What's going on, everybody? It's your boy T-Pinell. Welcome back to T-Pinell Auto. Today we are putting in mats in the trunk on this part and on the back seat of the trunk as well. You put a lot of stuff in your trunk, you don't want it to get damaged, tore up, a bunch of stuff all on here. I live in South Florida. It's the beach. It's much easier to clean sand off of rubber mats than it is this cloth carpet material. So we're gonna do that today. And the dope part about these mats, I read, hopefully that's true, you can still lift up and get access to your safe and anything else you need access to in here. So that's gonna be cool as well. I do have rubber mats that I purchased with the vehicle that are inside. I don't know why I thought that if you purchase the mats, a rubber mat would also come in the trunk. When I had my Range Rover and I purchased the mats, they came all throughout the car, but not with the Bronco. So I purchased some myself off of Amazon. I'm gonna link that down in the description below. You can also check the description and check out all the mods I put together on my vehicle, some that I plan on doing, and even a wish list. All right, this is me popping open the first package, and I actually thought these were these mats, but I think these are to the back seat. And it comes with a nice Velcro on the back, so we can go right ahead and get that on. They didn't come with any directions, but I shouldn't need any. But knowing me, I might. All right, I'm gonna skip this and do the floor part first. Yeah, here we are. This is a good base to get me started. Let's see. Okay. Is that it on this? I don't think so. Let's try it this way. All right, so here that is right here. It just kind of lay. It doesn't have a Velcro on these bottom ones, but I'm pretty sure this will fall down after usage. So it won't be like sticking up like this, but after I start putting things in, it'll kind of like relax down a little bit. All right, now onto the front part. We have the long piece and a short piece. So I'm guessing the two side seats connected, so that'll go there. And the one side seat is, and it's on its lonesome, so that'll go there. But I'm not sure if these lines should go up or down. Be nice if it told me something here. So let's put this on first. Boom, this will go here. Place like so. That looks good. We come across to this side. Okay. Wow, this looks really good. Pretty good, guys. Now, I don't know what the hell I'm supposed to do with this. Where in the world does this go? So, this part, I have no damn clue. Let me do some research.
2 weeks later.
So I just wanted to come in here and do this the correct way. I'm not mic'd up. I just wanted to do it the right way, so I didn't hear a bunch of yelling in the comments. So you have to lift this up. Lift it on up, lift it on up. Twist it around. Patty cake, all of that great stuff. I've been driving around with these wrong for about 2 weeks now. Gonna fix them up now. Get her lined up. Get her lined up. Lift this up. This is important. Sticks down. Perfect. Now we put these pieces on. Here they are. These are at the bottom.
looks good. These are the other side. Good. Good. Slide this back. Looks good. Now, I think this is officially the correct way of doing things. Put the seats back and give y'all a view. There we have it. Quick pop in. I'm gonna straighten that up right now. A little lopsided right here. But other than that, looks good.
Thank y'all so much for tuning in to another video. Tell me what y'all think about these. Link in the description. Check out all my other mods. There's a whole list of everything down in the description. Click on some of the greatness that's popping up on your screen, and I'll see y'all soon.